very warm welcome to Bharata First. You're watching Big Picture. I'm Frank Rausen Pereira. Since you're here, I would like to thank you for your continued support. For those of you who haven't already subscribed, please like the video, subscribe, hit the bell icon, and then all notifications. Do follow our social media handles for all the latest updates, and you can also subscribe to our newsletter to get some incisive content. The Bharata First team runs a daily Big Picture quiz. Please do participate by going through the description in the Big Picture videos. Here are the UPI IDs for those of you who would like to come forward and contribute. A small contribution that you make will be a giant leap for us to keep bringing you this content. Do continue to show your love and support. All the information is in the description of the video, so please go through it. And now to the discussion. As India is faced with an acute shortage of COVID-19 vaccines, the center has announced for the first time that it is in talks with three global manufacturers to supply India, Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson vaccines. The government has said on Thursday that the three pharma behemoths had communicated that they would be only able to begin discussions in Q3 2021. Despite this, the government estimates that over 2 billion doses of COVID-19 vaccines will be available for India between August and December this year, based on the estimates from the vaccine manufacturers. So it looks like in due course of time, we will all have vaccines. In this edition of Big Picture, we will analyze the vaccine roadmap for India. Joining me on the program today are Dr. K. Madan Gopal, Senior Consultant Health, Niti Aayog, Professor Sharman Singh, Director Ames Bhopal, and Aditi Tandon, Special Correspondent of the Tribune. Thank you to all my guests for joining me on this edition of Big Picture. Dr. Madan Gopal, let me start the program with you first. Let's first try and understand and analyze, you know, what should our vaccine strategy or vaccine roadmap be going forward? The government has announced that we'll try and have at least, the requisite number of vaccines in the near future. What should our roadmap look like?
The roadmap is quite encouraging. If you look at the way the vaccine has been developed in the country, way back in the from the ramparts of the Red Fort, when the Prime Minister announced, the whole effort started before that itself, that we would be having indigenous vaccine, and we were being able to roll out this indigenous vaccine. Ramping up of the vaccine capacities have also started before that. That means at that time, the capacities of these vaccines were 3 crores, 1 crore. Now they are having a capacity of 7 crores per month, which would be ramped up slowly and slowly. We can see around 20 crore vaccines by July. And the horizon, which was shown in the yesterday's Press Information Bureau meeting, we are in the process. The horizon is that we would, by the end of this year, we would be having around 200 crore doses of vaccines, which would be able to cover all the priority groups. That is, in the phase one, we have targeted health and wellness, healthcare workers, then the frontline workers, then the 60 plus population, 45 plus population, now 18 to 20. That means by December, I think if the things goes as planned, as we are seeing the horizon of the vaccine, which would be made available in the coming days, we would be able to complete the whole of this, covering all this population by end of this year.
Great. So that's some good news, really, as far as our vaccines are concerned, and the road ahead looks better than what we've seen over the last 2 months or so. Professor Sarman Singh, let me come to you now. You know, what has been the biggest issue, really, as far as our vaccine strategy is concerned? And, you know, how do you see it changing going forward?
Yeah, little bit, you know, what Dr. Madan Gopal said, I will be sounding pessimistic, but I am not. Why I am saying so? Because I think remaining the vaccine, if we are saying that, you know, we will have the vaccine by September or October, my priority, if given a choice and if all the logistics are ready, the whole country should be vaccinated as early as possible. We cannot afford to have 7 months or 8 months vaccination. Because what will happen by that the previously vaccinated people, they will have mutants, and then they will not have the antibody which are neutralizing. So that may be one of the concern and fear, that we may have escape mutants by that time, and therefore we need to have at least 1 crore vaccinations daily. That should be the target.
Okay, let's see if we can get to that target and how soon we can get to that target. Aditi, do you see us getting to that target? Of course, we've seen the vaccine development companies suggesting and stating that they are finding it difficult to provide and produce the kind of vaccines that we require. We saw Adar Poonawalla very clearly, categorically saying in an interview that that is not possible and he cannot take so much of a burden and it continues to be a big problem. Do you see it continuing to be a big problem going forward as well?
Frank, I do see a problem going forward simply because the projections that have been shared by the government with respect to vaccine availability are very optimistic. And to quote Dr. Vinod Kumar Paul, who mentioned yesterday that these estimates from the industry are optimistic estimates and we would all like them to come true. But as Dr. Sarman Singh said, everything is in the womb of the future. Let's not forget that we are among the few countries, Frank, that have opened up their vaccinations for the adult population before actually covering the entire vulnerable groups. Healthcare workers, frontline workers, people above 60 years, and then the other phase of people above 45 years are yet to be vaccinated. What is the percentage of people we've covered above 45 years? That's 32% at the national level. Some states have done very well. For instance, Ladakh has covered 80% plus population in the 45 plus age group. But the question is, Frank, according to me, because I am a journalist and I have a ringside view and I can look at things dispassionately, I think India has rushed into opening up vaccinations for the adult population. We could have waited for one more month so that people who have been covered with the first dose above 45 years of age could have easily gotten access to the second dose, and we could have at least had some pool of population with some kind of vaccine-induced antibodies. Right now, what is happening, if I've taken my first dose, I'm having problems looking for the second dose and schedules are all going haywire. Naturally, everybody understands vaccine production is not an overnight job. It is not easy, especially for a country like India, which is basing its program on Made in India vaccines, Frank. And don't forget that we have 95 crore adult population, which means we need 1.9 billion doses guaranteed. Absolutely. Although the government is saying that we will have 2 billion doses of the vaccine between August and December, but we all understand that they are basing their production estimates on yet to be licensed vaccines. For instance, Biological E, for instance, Genova, for instance, Bharat Biotech's nasal vaccine. These are vaccines in stages of trials, although many of them are at late stage trials, but they're yet to be licensed by the regulator. And so, to base your estimates for the future on vaccines which have not been licensed, I don't know how pragmatic an approach that is.
Absolutely. Okay. So since we are here, then Dr. Madan Gopal, let's try and address this particular aspect as well. How should we address this going forward? What should our strategy be? How do we address the challenges that may come about? Because since we are all talking about the future, even the vaccines are not immediately available. They will be available in the future. What should our strategy be? How do we prepare for this?
Hey, we have to stick to the same strategy because initially we started with the healthcare workers and the frontline workers, and we have been able to cover 80 to 90% of them, at least 70% of the healthcare workers and the frontline workers, they have got two shots of vaccination. Everybody knew that we don't have the production capacities, but there was some pressure and it was a decision taken in consultation with the state to open up the vaccination for 18 plus population with the notion that they would be procuring the vaccination from the manufacturers and they would be inoculating this population. That's another thing. And if you look at the progression in which we are doing the vaccination, we are doing it at lot speed, but only constraint factor is the supplies. We are producing around 7 crores and that number, if you see, has been increasing. 7 crores vaccination of both this Covishield and this Covaxin. Now Sputnik has also joined. Now you would be having more vaccines. So till now we have inoculated 18 crores. That means 14 crores around they have received around 10% population they have received at least one dose of vaccination. That's one thing. We have to see that how whatever vaccination which is available across the globe, whatever stockpiles are there, we have to see that the stockpiles have to be brought so that as early as possible, we should be covering at least this 95%, 95 crore population with at least a single dose of vaccine. That's the way we have to go forward. And the second thing is, there is a common notion saying that wherever the cases are peaking, we should be doing vaccination. Vaccination takes time for showing its effect. Whichever districts which are not showing any peak, where the transmission is less, we should be focusing on that district so that at least a ring fence is there. If you look at how the forest fires have been dodged, if you look at that, they usually cut the trees around that forest where the fire is there, so that the adjoining areas of the forest does not catch fire. So we have to adopt a similar kind of thing. Whichever districts which are not having a high transmission, we have to see that how the population they protect, because the infection will invariably go there. Till the time infection go, they would be protected. That could be one strategy. Second thing is, the other notion is that whatever vulnerable population, as the I think when you pointed out that only 33% of the 45 plus population has been immunized, we have to just push for getting more and more population of this age group to be vaccinated, because one of the important things about this pandemic is we have to prevent the deaths in this population. The most vulnerable section is 45 plus population, who account for 80% of all the deaths. So the strategy which we are following, we have to see that how it is more pragmatized and how best the available vaccines which are there, we have to put that into use. So we have to go in that direction.
So the strategy that we have is a good strategy. Supplies have been a problem in the past. Once the supplies are taken care of, then the strategy will fall into place and we'll ensure that we go in the right direction, is what Dr. Madan Gopal is suggesting. So, Professor Sarvan Singh, let me come back to you now. You know, from an implementation point of view, coming down to the last mile, how do we implement it? Do we have enough manpower? Do we have enough, expertise as far as actually inoculating such a large population?
You see, the ideal situation, what Dr. Madan Gopal has said, this is a typical ideal if everything happens. But unfortunately, that is not the case. Earlier, when frontline workers and healthcare workers and more than 45 people, they were asked to get vaccinated, the vaccine was more, and the volunteers, or what we can say, that those who wanted to get vaccinated, they were less. And despite repeated appeals from Honorable Prime Minister and Health Minister, people were not coming forward. And therefore, I was also one of them, those who advocated that, yes, why not let it be opened for the more than 18 to 45. The reason behind, I still stand with my statement, that the reason was that they are also very much likely to spread the infection. Yes, of course, more than 45, they are more vulnerable. But this group, 18 to 45, is the most, I can say, carrier, which can, take the virus from one end to another. So that was the reason. Now, I would, if not as a government employee, but in personal capacity, I am saying, my rider is there. So I am still saying that, the government should not try and hustle the clinical trials. Some of the Zydus and other vaccines, they are still in the clinical trial. What they did, that the Covaxin also, that was there. So Covaxin, that it got lot of negativity because this was hushed up before the clinical trial was there. So my request, as a citizen as well as an expert, and also to some extent as a government employee, I would say, to make the good the impression about the vaccines, they should not hush up the early. So the trial should be genuine, they should be published, they should be peer reviewed, and then only they should be brought to the program.
I think that's a very valid point that Professor Sarman is making. Aditi, I'd like to take that up with you and take it forward with you. There is this whole vaccine hesitancy also that the professor was talking about, and we saw that in the past when the vaccines were ready, the people were not ready to take them, and still there is some kind of hesitancy because they believe that all the information is not being revealed. How do we change this first and foremost from both sides, from vaccine hesitancy point of view as well, and from the government's point of view to give out more information? And with more vaccines coming in now, we have the Sputnik and the others too on the way. Pfizer is also coming to India. So will this change the way we look at vaccines as a whole?
Yeah, I think the problem earlier was vaccine hesitancy, as Dr. Sarman Singh pointed out very eloquently. Even the health workers were not ready to take a lot of vaccines. I think part of the problem also arose, Frank, because a lot of countries that started inoculating people before India did, for instance, the UK, for instance, countries like Brazil, etc., also, you know, countries like the US, there were some reported incidents of clotting on account of AstraZeneca shot. So, you know, all that also contributed to the vaccine hesitancy in the earlier days. Earlier days, meaning when the inoculation was opened up January 16, and then you remember on February 2, it was opened up for frontline workers after the health workers were invited to take the vaccines. That time, the problem was of hesitancy. Today, the problem is of vaccine eagerness. So, you know, there has to be an extremely fine balance between vaccine hesitancy and eagerness so that we reach out the right kind of messaging. The fact of the matter is every vaccine which is in the market has been published with solid research, and every vaccine that is available right now in the markets has been shown to work, has been shown to prevent severe disease and prevent death. I would just like to mention here that there is not enough literature yet in important health journals to establish that these vaccines are also preventing transmission. But the fact of the matter is they do give some kind of protection against transmission, but most of them give a lot of protection against severe disease and death, which is exactly what most countries are focusing on. Because when the history of the epidemic will be written, Frank, the most important data point at that time will be how many lives were lost. That's where the countries will be compared. In fact, let me mention here that India has not done very badly on case fatality rate, provided what we are told is the truth. Because there are certain concerns about underreporting of deaths. We are in a situation where we are actually seeing bodies washing up across rivers on the shores. So, you know, it's not a very happy situation. So people have to get convinced that vaccines are going to prevent death and that they must immediately go and take vaccines. Every vaccine available is good. So there has to be no confusion in the minds whether I should take Covishield or Covaxin. Everything works against severe disease. People just need to go and protect themselves from disease and death so that our health systems are not overwhelmed.
Absolutely. All right. Time to get closing comments now from all my panelists with the best way forward. Starting first with you, Dr. Madan Gopal.
The best way is, as Aditi has mentioned, that whatever vaccine is available, if you get a chance, you take that chance and go for the vaccine jab. That's the only tool which is available right now. And apart from that, we should not be lowering our guard when the cases are coming down. We have to follow that COVID-appropriate behavior, and we have to see that how we build that behavior into our ongoing thing. Because the moment the guard is lower, you are staring at another surge. Over to you,
please. Absolutely. Professor Sarman?
Yeah, again, I would say that it has to be a multi-pronged approach. You know, we have to have sufficient infrastructure, the healthcare facilities, human resource, as well as the vaccine, and of course the mass masking, which is very, very important. We cannot afford to be complacent, and we should not be very happy when few thousand of number of the cases comes down, we start cheering up. So that is somehow I don't like that.
Right. And Aditi, close the show for us with your quick concluding remark.
I just want to say, Frank, that to expand the vaccination basket, it is very important for the government to take certain strategic priority decisions. For instance, NTAGI, which is our Standing Committee on Vaccinations, which guides the country, has in its last meeting decided to recommend to the government that people who have been infected with COVID should delay their shots for 6 months after recovery, as against 8 weeks after recovery, which is the current protocol. This is a sound decision. The WHO has already recommended it. There is literature available to show that people who have got COVID once, lab-confirmed COVID, actually get about 80% protection from disease for 7 months. So it is a decision if India takes, you know, it will be able to stagger the vaccinations for everybody. Also, I think we need to focus on single shot vaccines, and Bharat Biotech's nasal vaccine is also promising, because these candidates will take lesser time to reach people.
All right. We'll have to leave to that. Thank you so much to all my guests for joining me on the program and putting things into perspective for us. What's coming out of this discussion is that the vaccine roadmap is a step in the right direction. Our strategy for inoculation was always good. Unfortunately, the manufacturing, procurement and supply was poor. That is what we have to change going forward. We have to continue to protect the vulnerable and focus on areas that are not just being badly affected by the virus, but on others as well, so that we ensure that everyone is covered and the pandemic does not go out of hand once again. Till the time a vaccine jab is available, we have to continue to follow COVID-appropriate behavior, because that is the best cure that we have right now. Once again, thank you for your continued support. For those of you who haven't already subscribed, please like the video, subscribe, hit the bell icon, and then all notifications. Do follow our social media handles for all the latest updates, and you can also subscribe to our newsletter to get some incisive content. The Bharata First team runs a daily Big Picture quiz. Please do participate by going through the description in the Big Picture videos. Here are the UPI IDs for those of you who would like to come forward and contribute. A small contribution you make will be a giant leap for us to keep bringing you this content. So do continue to show your love and support. All the information is in the description of this video. Kindly go through it. That's it from me. See you again next time.